Surrounded on all sides by industry and transportation, Georgetown has emerged as one of the last vestiges of Seattle's funky and alternative past. Artist studios and breweries scatter along wide roads. However, the neighborhood hasn't always had this distinctive character. Georgetown is located along the eastern shore of the Duwamish River, south of downtown Seattle. The area is the ancestral, unceded land of the Duwamish people. European settlers were initially drawn to the area for its abundant fishing and lush vegetation. They soon cleared this vegetation and planted crops in the fertile soil. As the settlement grew, it attracted industry and more residents. The town was incorporated into the city of Georgetown in January of 1904 and established its government in the City Hall building. The city was later annexed by Seattle in 1910, which coincided with the onset of a period of industrialization in the area. In 1913, Seattle city engineers began work to straighten the Duwamish River, filling in the mudflats along its shores to create viable new land for industrial development.
As the settlement grew, it rapidly industrialized. Hops grew very well in the soil, and a number of breweries sprang up in the 1880s, the largest of which was the Seattle Brewing and Malting Company. They became the world's sixth largest brewery and later became Rainier Brewing. The clay from the riverbank was used to make bricks and tiles in the early 1900s, and the railroad in the region operated out of the city. The Boeing Company grew into a Seattle manufacturing powerhouse and nationwide air transportation system by the early 1930s. The attack on Pearl Harbor in 1941 sparked an unprecedented explosion in Washington's aviation history. To protect the Boeing factory, building thousands of airplanes from any aerial attacks, a plan was devised to camouflage it. John Stewart, a skilled set designer from Hollywood, was employed to design and draw a fake town to be constructed above the factory. Painters and sculptors were employed in making fake streets, sidewalks, trees, fences, cars, and houses on the factory roof. The grass and trees were made of chicken feathers and glass fibers. Small fake homes were built of fiberglass and plywood, mimicking an American suburban neighborhood.
Georgetown is a neighborhood that has historically been a haven for artists. These artists and their communities have contributed to the neighborhood's character and revival. It is one of the last bastion of the bohemian blue-collar art community in Seattle. One of the most popular events in Georgetown is the Georgetown Art Attack, a monthly art walk that draws hundreds of visitors to explore the galleries, studios, and businesses that showcase the local art. In 2006, Sam Farazino, a sculptor, leased an old World War II-era factory in the Georgetown to build and organize a 100% artist-owned space. Home to over 125 artists, Equinox Studios is now a sprawling complex of artist studios and workshops waiting to expand. In 2010, the Georgetown Trailer Park Mall was conceived as a unique outdoor shopping experience featuring a collection of vintage trailers, each transformed into a tiny shop selling everything from handmade jewelry to vintage clothing and home decor.
The industries in Georgetown have always had a creative flair. They have left their mark on the Seattle neighborhood. The area surrounding the site is a rich tapestry of exposed brick and large blank industrial facades. The presence of Georgetown's creative residents can be seen as a layer on top of the industrial base. Today, Georgetown is decorated with many murals, formal and informal. Some homes in the residential neighborhoods are artfully decorated, and many have projects in their backyard. Despite the relocation of Rainier Brewing, there are many new breweries in the neighborhood. Georgetown Brewing Co. is one of the best known and fastest growing of these breweries. Located in an old brewery space, it is brewing continuing the neighborhood's legacy. The neighborhood still has a strong presence of artists and galleries. They exist in the context of brick and mortar and the sounds of passing trains and low-flying planes. the tight-knit community of artists and local business owners have managed to retain local businesses through community activism, collaboration, and a commitment to preserving the neighborhood's unique character and history.